வெல்கம் டு நரேஷை டெக்னாலஜிஸ் திஸ் இஸ் ராம்சந்தர் இந்த லாஸ்ட் வீடியோ ஐ டிட் டு டாக் அபவுட் ப்ரோக்ராம் ஆன் சிங்கிள் லெவல் இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ் ஆர் சிங்கிள் இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ் வாட் எவர் இட் மேபி அண்ட் ஆல்சோ ஐ டிட் டாக் அபவுட் ஹைப்ரிட் இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ் எஸ்பெஷலி இன் திஸ் வீடியோ ஐம் கோயிங் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் அபவுட் ப்ரோக்ராம் ஆன் மல்டி லெவல் இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ் மல்டி லெவல் inheritance in Java. Good, nice. Now, already we guys know that multiple inheritance means a class which is interacting with other than object class is called multi-level inheritance. We can say like this, the one particular class, it should be behave like a super class as well as subclass. That type of inheritance also we can call it as what? Multi-level inheritance. For example, see, this is object, this is the A, and this is what here, B. Three classes I'm taking here. One is object, another one is what, A, and another one is what here, B. Now, A is interact with the object, as well as B is interact with the A. So, the same class behave like a what? Subclass as well as what here? Superclass is called what here? Multi-level inheritance. Now, observe guys. First, let me draw one small program. Let me develop one program on top of this concept. For that purpose, I am taking notepad here. As usual, our main class name is test. In the test class, we need to take one method, public static void main, yes, string array, yes. Now, enough, let me compile, let me save this one. What is this? Test.java and all files and save it. Now, let me take two classes, class A and class B. Now, here I am writing like, int A equal to 111 and static int B equal to 222 as well as int C equal to 333 int D equal to 444 later I am taking one method like void M1 and after that here I am writing one normal SOP statement. What is that? B class M1 method. So as usual, I'm taking one static method. That static method name is static void M2. Here, this is M2. And let me copy this one and save, paste here. But here I am taking some different method names like M3. This is A class M3 method. And this is A class M4 method. Yes, let me take here M4. Let me save it. Now observe guys. Java C, test.java. So whatever the program we written, syntactically correct. But let me write some code in the test class. What is that code? Observe. BOBJ equal to newbie. BOBJ equal to newbie. So here, multiple inheritance means a class which is interacting with other than object class is called what here? Multi-level. So multi-level means we are getting the feature from more than one class. That is what here? Multi-level. Not at a time. One more point. At a time means what here? That is comes under multiple. Now, class B extends of A. Here I given one definition like a class which extracting more than one class. So, here more than one class means what here? B is extends of A. A is extends of object. So, whatever the features which we have in the object, those are coming to A. And both object and A features are coming to where here? B. More than one class. That is multi-level. Now, observe guys. Now, very important point here is the entire Java is depend upon this way of calling statements and calling methods and variables. If whenever we creating an object, whenever we creating an object in general manner means both reference type and reference memory. Here reference is what here? OBJ. Here memory is related to which class? B class. Reference type is what here? B. Both reference type and reference memory are same. Internally, compiler having some functionality, JVM having some functionality. What is compiler having functionality? Compiler always concentrate on reference. Compiler always concentrate on reference variable type. What is the reference variable here? Here reference variable is OBJ. And what type it is? The type of OBJ is B type. So if you are calling any variable or any method, compiler will go and check in which class? B class. In the same manner, JVM also having its own functionality. It is always concentrate on reference memory. So what is the reference memory here? New B. Reference memory is what here? New B. Now, if you are in the execution mode, JVM always concentrate on variables and methods on top of what here? Memory only. So if we have one more approach that we will see in coming videos, like upcasting and downcasting, in that particular time, both compiler and JVM functionality will be changes. So compiler always, functionality always changes, but JVM little bit of functionality will changes, that we will see in coming videos. Now, observe guys, here I'm calling one variable, like system.out.println, obj.a. So system.out.println, obj.a means, first compiler is going to concentrate on which variable are we calling. Here I am calling what here? Variable A. By using what? Reference variable. What is the reference variable here? OBJ. So I told you already, whenever we creating an object in the general manner, like a reference type and a reference memory both are same, what is the duty of the compiler? It will always concentrate on reference variable type. What is the reference variable here? OBJ. What type it is? B type. So compiler go and check in which class? B class. About which variable? A variable. Do you have any A? No. If you don't have variable A in the B class, automatically control goes to A class. That means, if you don't have any data in the subclass, automatically control goes to superclass. What is the nearest superclass for B? A. So then control go to A class and it will checking about A variable. Do you have any A variable? Do you have any A variable in the A class? Let me go and check. Yes. What is the value? 111. The 111 will bind it to what here? OBJ. But in the execution time, memory management, I'm communicating with the value and printing the value, everything is taken care by JVM. So what JVM is doing here, it will concentrate on memory. What is the memory of OBJ? That memory of OBJ is what here? B class. So JVM go and check in which class? B class memory. Do you have any variable A? No. Then automatically control goes to variable A class. Do you have any variable A? Yes. What is the value? 111. It will be printed on the console. Now, clear the screen and Java C test.java and Java test. What are the value? 111. Nice. In the same manner, let me go and check Control C and Control V. Now, so let me print variable B value. So as usual, same thing. Whenever we writing like system.out.println obj.b, compiler is going to check B variable existence in object reference. So reference variable type here. Here reference variable is OBJ. So what type it is? B class. So compiler go and check in which class? B class. Do you have any B variable? No. Then control goes to variar. It's a nearest superclass. What is the nearest superclass? A class. Do you have any B variable? Yes. That variable will be binding. But JVM is executing from the memory. What is the memory here? New B. But in the new B, we don't have any B variable. So again, control goes to variar A and will pick 222 and print it on the console. Yes. In the same manner, like control C and control V. Now here I'm taking like variable C comma variable D. Then in this particular time, what happened? Compiler will go and check a C variable in the OBJ type. What is the OBJ type here? B type. So control go and check in B class. About which variable? C variable. Do you have any C? Yes. that will be binded to OBJ. And JVM is also executing from the memory. What is the memory here? New B. So JVM will go and call 333 and print it on the console. Now here Java C test.java and Java test. So what the value? 444 and 333. So this functionality not only workful for, not only it will executing on top of the, are implemented on top of the what here variables, but it is also implemented on top of the where methods. So my method name here, what is this? M3. So I'm calling M3 method. So definitely compiler will go and check the OBJ reference type, that is a B type. Yes, control go and check M3 method in the B class. We don't have M3 method, so definitely it will goes to where? A class. It will find out what here M3 method in the A class. Then finally it will call. Then what happened? A class M3 method will be executing by the JVM. Yes, in the same manner, there is no doubt about that. The everything will be happen like this. Yes, what is this? This is the M2 and this is the M1 and as well as what M4. So M1 and M2 is available in the B class. So both the compiler find out M1, M2 in the B class and JVM execute them. And M3, M4 methods are not available in the B class and compiler will find out in A class and JVM will executing from A class itself. So the output is two methods from A and two methods from what? B. Two methods from A and two methods from what? B here. So this is the way of executing variables and methods from the classes. Now maybe you guys are having the doubt like whenever we writing like static int C equal to 333 are very let me take non-static variable control C, and one more thing is let me take better to take 555 for more clarity, and this is the same variable I'm placing into varier B itself. Now I'm wants to print here, I'm taking not C here, better to take different variable, that is E. And here is also I'm taking different variable like E. Yes, here he is in the previous example or whatever the program we seen up to now, A and B and C and D are different variables. But in this particular time, E is available in the A class as well as what here? B class. Now, let me try to call control C and as well as control V. Here I'm writing like what here? OBJ.E. So as usual, whenever we call obj.e, compiler go and check in which class? B class. Do you have any E variable? Yes. So that E variable will be binded to what? Object or reference. And JVM is also concentrate on memory. Here the memory is what your new B. So definitely E variable will be executing from B class itself. So let me go and check Java C test.java and Java test. What is the value we got? And 666. That means if the data is existed in the subclass, control is not going to, it's a super class. In which scenario? If you are creating an object in general manner. In the upcasting and downcasting manner is different, that we will see in coming videos. I hope you enjoy this video. For more videos, please subscribe to Naresh IT channel. Thank you. Catch you in the next video.